Once upon a time, there was a little old lady. She lived in a nice house with a white picket fence all the way around. And she did love her flowers. Most of all, she loved her tulips. And she planted them every spring on either side of the walk going to her front door. And she waited every spring for them to pop through the ground. She watched and watched, and pretty soon she saw the little green leaves popping through the ground. Weeks went by, and every day she waited, and sure enough, pretty soon they began to bloom. Red ones, yellow ones, white ones, purple ones, and ones with red and white stripes. Oh, how she loved those tulips. And she knew that every spring, when the moon was full, and there was a circle around the moon, that the pixies came to dance. When I lived with my grandmother, she would take me for walks down by the river. Actually, it was probably an irrigation ditch, but it seemed like a big amount of water to me. And she'd sit and read poetry. And I remember she would read a poem that went, "There are fairies at the bottom of my garden. It's not so very, very far away. You just go through the shed and then go straight ahead. I do so hope they've really come to stay." And when she would read that poem to me, I could see those fairies. She'd also tell me not to knock over the toadstools because that's where the fairies live. And we'd float paper boats down the river, and as they floated down the river, I could imagine doing all kinds of exciting things in that boat. I'd really love to dream as a child, perhaps still do. But storytelling is a form of communication, perhaps one of the oldest forms we have. It's a way of showing a love and respect for each other. So I'm always feel a little badly when people clap because I'm not supposedly entertaining them. I'm sharing with them something that I enjoy and I've loved, so I want them to hear about it. One really cute story recently was, I started out a story like I often do, and I said, "Once upon a time," and this little girl held up her hand and said, "Oh, I've heard that story." And you know, it's too bad that often we separate the children from old people, because adults, particularly old people, really need to watch children. And I used to tell stories in the lounge at the library, where older men and women would sit around reading the evening newspaper in the afternoon, or reading a magazine. And often I would notice a man with a newspaper up in front of him, and he'd kind of peek around the side to watch the children, but also to listen to the story. We're never too old to listen to a story. Lady knew that those pixies didn't want to be watched. So she'd go upstairs to her room and peek from behind the curtain. And sure enough, she saw the pixies come. And the men would get ready to dance in the pixie ring while the mothers brought their babies and put them into the tulips. It was just like a cradle. And when the breeze would blow, the tulips would go to and fro, and rock the pixies to sleep while the mothers danced. After many years, the little old lady got very old, and she had to sell her house. And can you imagine, she sold her house to people who didn't like flowers. They pulled up her snapdragons, they pulled up her hollyhocks, They pulled up her little Johnny jump-ups. And worst of all, they pulled up all of her tulips. And they threw all the flowers out into the field next door. And in the place of the flowers, they planted cabbage, cauliflower, Brussels sprouts, and squash. And then, where the little old lady had always planted her tulips for the pixies to sleep in, they planted parsley. Well, sure enough, that next spring, when there was a full moon and a circle around the moon, the pixies came to dance in the pixie ring. And when they found there were no tulips, but there was just parsley growing, it made them so mad they pinched it, and they pinched it, and they pinched it. That's why parsley has curly leaves. Now, as for the tulips, fortunately, the people who bought their house, the little old lady's house, threw all those tulip bulbs out into a heap on top of weeds and dirt, and they began to bloom again. So that next spring, when there was a full moon and a circle around the moon, the pixies came back to dance and put their babies into one of the tulip cradles. And when the wind would blow, it would go to and fro, and rock the babies sound asleep while their mothers and fathers danced. And don't worry, because if you grow tulips at your house, you look at each one and you smell it, and you'll know which ones the pixie babies slept in, because they have a specially sweet fragrance. And so I guess you could say I live in a fantasy world, but you can't tell me there isn't magic out there. You just have to believe it, that's all.